আরেকবার আপনাদের স্বাগত জানাই ব্রেকিং 12টায়। 3 মাস পরে ডানলপ খুললে পরেও এখনো কিন্তু সেখানে সম্পূর্ণ সমস্যার সমাধান হয়নি। আমরা দেখেছি মালিক পক্ষের সঙ্গে দুই শ্রমিক ইউনিয়নের আলোচনার পরে কিন্তু যেটা মালিক পক্ষের তরফ থেকে বলা হয়েছিল যে ধাপে ধাপে সমস্যার সমাধান ঘটবে। আজ এই মুহূর্তে সাংবাদিক সম্মেলন করছেন পবন রুই, আমরা সরাসরি চলে যাচ্ছি সেখানে।
If people are far behind, they want to come in front, then there can be one more row here. You all have known that the Dunlop factory Shahganj has already started for maintenance. In last 3 months of time, we have been seeing a lot many reports about Dunlop. There was huge confusion. We thought that if we clarify each and every issues which is giving rise to any confusion or any sort of feeling which a lot of people have, and that is how this press conference was summoned. Before we go on to the question answers, I would like to say that in November we had to close down the plant on 30th of November because some way or the other we could not reach to a conclusion with the unions. The negotiation was on since October, where we offered them to pay 2,000 rupees per month to each and every worker. Time the said that we expect the plant to reopen latest by March, maybe before that. There were a few section of the people who, I would say in disguise of the union, were trying to create problems, maybe numbering in 25-30, and for some reason the entire common consciousness could not come in, and ultimately we have to take a decision of the suspension of operation. But we were trying hard to see that when the plant could start, and on 6th of March we have resumed the work with 229 people in engineering and maintenance department to start the plant. Unfortunately, in this 3-4 months of time, there has been a lot of thefts which has taken place. We could never expect such type of mass theft which has taken place inside the factory, which to some extent lot of brass item, the copper item, the aluminium item has completely been just taken away. People have entered inside, they have broken the locks, the lock was lying there, they opened the drawers, they have taken out all the tools, jigs and everything. We have put the people on and we are trying to resume to bring the plant back to the normal situation as fast as possible, which I assume will not take more than 1 to 1.5 months of time. So it means we expect the production to be on in next couple of months time. There was an apprehension that we will only take this 229 people and then we will just continue and rest of the people will not be taken, or this is just an eyewash of taking the people inside. We have read some such news in the paper as well. But let me assure that this plant is certainly going to start. It is not only 229 people, the entire people will be taken in, and there is not going to be any retrenchment or any reduction in labor. We will go at this particular moment with 30 to 40 tons a day. We'll try and stabilize the plant at that particular position for some time and then gradually lead up to the production. I have been mentioning in the past several times that we had problems in the past where somebody was trying to sabotage our increase in production. We tried to increase the production in the past from 30 tons to 90 tons, and every time we tried to increase this production, there was some important part in the plant was made purposefully, it was tampered with, and the entire plant is to come to shut down. We tried to locate, we tried to find out what the exact reason was, but we some way or the other were not able to exactly locate the person or the group behind that who was trying to disturb such production. This time when we will stabilize the plant at 30 to 40 tons, we will ensure that such type of tampering with the production doesn't take place and the plant can increase its production in due course of time. So this two, barring these 229 people out of 1169 or 1170 which people are there right now, will be taken in inside the factory in a phased manner. So long as the issue is concerned with the few people who are trying to demonstrate outside the east gate of the factory, who are not letting some of the people enter inside, there has been issues on Saturday where our management staff was manhandled, they were not let in. The necessary FIR has been filed by the company and the administration is taking care about that. On the first day we had 81 people coming in, on the second day 86, and today there is 100 people who have already joined in the duty, which belongs to both the faction, the C2 and the INTUC.
86 on Saturday.
The 81 on Friday, on the 6th, the on Saturday 86, and today it is 100, exactly 100. And I confirm to say that these workers belong to both the factions, the INTUC as well as C2. If we see the entire problem being created, or if we see the entire people who are demonstrating outside the East Gate, I would say few of them are the employees of the company and few of them are not connected to the company at all. Out of the total lot of 1170 people, the problem being created by some small number of people numbering 25-30 has already been charge sheeted by the company, and company in the due course will take an action as will be appropriately advised by the legal advisors of the company. I personally feel that gradually this 100 numbers will increase, because the message has gone to a lot of workers who are not here in Calcutta or who may have taken temporarily assignment in some other factory. And we have got the message that in next week we will have majority of these 209 people joining in the duty. If you recall, when we said that we will pay 2,000 rupees each month for the period when the plant will be in operation, I mean when we did not shut down the suspension, when we declared the suspension operation. Today I am announcing to pay rupees 1,000 to each and every worker, barring the charge sheeted people, as an ad hoc payment to tie over their urgent needs, as the Holi festival is also coming in. So till we come to a formal conclusion or till we come to a formal understanding with the union, this 1,000 rupees will be paid to each and every worker barring the charge-sheeted people immediately. And this money will be adjusted with whatever is being final, will be finalized with the unions in due course of time. We are hearing when a lot of people say in some of the press that there is no electricity, there is no water, and how come the plant run with no electricity and no water? There is full water there. For your information, I would like to say that even in the closer period, the entire water which was supplied to the state was from the factory's borewell. So the entire news which is being said that there is no water inside the factory is completely wrong news. Coming back to the electricity, certainly when the plant was suspended, we had surrendered the electricity, as because in the past, when the electricity was not surrendered, company had a liability of more than 18 crore rupees for the electricity not disconnected by the electricity department while the plant was under closure. So this time we took a special care to see that no such liability comes onto the company, and hence the electricity was surrendered. For the maintenance purposes, the company has sufficient generators there which is giving electricity, and there is no shortage of any electricity there for completing the maintenance work. But for the production, certainly we will be requiring electricity, and our people are discussing and negotiating with the electricity department to see to get the electricity connection as fast as possible, which I'm quite sure will be there much before we require that power. Few more things I would like to highlight here about that, what this agitation is for. Why we are seeing so much of hue and cry, and what is that outstanding money which is due to the workers? There's a major issue which is there, that our money is outstanding, the company is not paying the money, and things like that. So the total money outstanding which the company owes to the workers is into three parts. Number one, the October and November wages, which will be paid as and when it is decided how much will it be paid, as against which 1,000 rupees I have just announced to pay them as an ad hoc. Number two, who have taken the VRS, in totality more than 1,500 people took the VRS, company paid more than 1,000 people, and 563 people were left over. Out of these 563 people who were outstanding to be paid VRS, we have already paid VRS to more than 42 people, and total amount was paid approximately 1 crore and 30 lakh rupees in this period when the plant was shut down. So as of right now, 521 people are left to be paid the VRS, and the company is trying to clear this money as soon as possible. I would also like to mention that there was an outstanding towards the Provident Fund. This outstanding related to two parts of outstanding: one, before the company was taken over by Ruya Group, and secondly, at the time when we took over the company after that. In this off period, we have paid 684 lakhs, 6 crore 84 lakhs as a PF. And I would say as of right now, there is no PF dues outstanding of any worker, be it employee shares, be it employer shares, in account of PF. In the books of PF, there's a small amount of 59 lakh rupees in interest outstanding, which is a disputed amount, and that relates to the period when plant was not in operation and no wages was paid. By mistake, a liability was created by PF department, which the matter is pending in the court, and we are sure that since no wages was paid, PF is not payable. So as of right now, there is no outstanding of any nature in the PF account. So long as ESI is concerned, entire ESI has been paid to the extent of 30 lakh rupees, and this money has again been paid during the closure period. all the people who have retired from the company up to 31st December 2008, the company has cleared their all outstanding whatever they may be. The only outstanding is for the month of January and February, which is not due as yet as because of the cooling off period. And once this cooling off period is there, they will also be paid their dues. So in totality, if you see today, the outstanding is only October and November wages, which is under negotiation. Number two, 521 people VRS. And number three, the OTS amount for the people who have been taken in, which 5,000 rupees per worker, and this amount is due to be paid to them only once 521 people are paid the VRS.
এতক্ষণ আপনারা দেখছিলেন রানলব কর্ণধার আর পবন রুইয়ার সাংবাদিক সম্মেলন সরাসরি। ব্রেকিং বারোটা আজ এ পর্যন্তই রয়েছে, আরো খবর সঙ্গে থাকুন 24 ঘন্টা।